Very good morning, folks. It's a really horrible dreich day. The rain's coming down, that fine mist, one that just soaks you to the skin. So I don't know what I'm going to do, folks. I've just come out for a little drive about, have a little explore. I don't know what to do, man. So I'm not, I don't think I'll be able to go for a walk or anything because I'm just going to get soaked. And the grass is going to be really wet underfoot. And I've actually got a blister on my big toe. Not the big toe, but the one beside the big toe. From yesterday, walking in the wet, I got a blister just from the chafing off the toes. So a bit sore there, but put some Vaseline on it. So, but yeah, so I don't think we're walking much today. I don't know what I'm gonna do, folks. Bit of a conundrum what to do today. Right, folks, here we are. You find me in Alexander Street, just off the hill town, where I've come to look at these signs, symbols that have been inserted into a wall. They've just built these houses here. So at the back of the wall, they've put in these little decorative symbols, and I'm not sure what they're all about. So we're just gonna have a little look, see so we can fathom what they mean. So there they are. They all seem to have similar sort of design, sort of circles and eyes. Sort of like elliptical things. What are they? Sort of metal. Metal with a sort of a plasticky sort of thing in the. Yeah, I'm not sure what they're all about, folks. I said these houses have just been built, so maybe it's just a decorative thing. Not too sure, but there they are. Not Pictish, obviously they're not Pictish, but they've got the same sort of vibe about them. There's one now, just like eyes or something, aren't they? And there's one that's a bit like a yin and yang sign, but hey ho, oh, there we go, that was them. So if anybody knows what they're all about, folks, then just let me know in the comments. Thank you. Now, just up the road here, there's this Hilltown Park or something. They've got all these bollards. Edible flowers. Courgettes. Patates. Oranges. Melons. It's obviously things kids have done, isn't it? Rhubarb. Currants. I've got the name of the kids that have done them as well. There we are. It's the Hilltown clock, isn't it? There we go. Here we go with guest speaker, Mr. David Attenborough in the house.
We encountered some of the world's most remarkable species of life. Only now do I realize just how lucky I am.
Ice caps are melting and the seas are rising higher. It's just nature, nature at its worst. Mountains are crumbling, should become extinct, wiped out in a whirlwind and you never even blinked. It's just nature, nature at its worst. Countries are burning, the world's on fire. Ice caps are melting and the seas are rising higher. It's just nature, nature at its worst. Mountains are crumbling, species become extinct, wiped out in a whirlwind, and you never even blink. Nature, that is war. Countries are burning, the world's on fire. Ice caps are melting and the seas are rising higher. It's just nature. That is
nature at its worst.
Hello, Lucky.
Well, folks, here I am with the this birdie. It's called Lucky. Now, to some amazing impersonations of its owner, and it shouts on dive and all this sort of amazing. The impersonation does, but obviously it's not going to do any noises just yet. Are you going to make a noise? I don't think it likes me very much. Where's Laura? Where's Laura? Where's Laura? Are Scotland going to win tonight?
Where are you?
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to upset you. Sorry. Okay, okay.
Yeah, I think it knows.
Where's Laura? Laura? Where's Laura?
I think it's your voice voice that's putting her off.
Go on then, off you go. Go on then.
All right, ugly. Come on, England.
Star of the documentary series Gone Fishing.
Yeah, we've got Reed. What Paul funny? Look at it.
Wow.
Dancing. Dance for our one.
Okay, let's see what this is all about then, shall we? Right, tonight for tea, folks, we're having a Greg's vegetable bake. Now, this is inspired by a guy I've just subscribed to, Hungry Nuts. He's a very camp dude, but he's a funny man. He's got this great sense that he's just his own man, isn't he? So he's really good. So I like watching him. So he does reviews on food. So I like, go check his kitchen out. It's almost dead 70s now. It's brilliant. Anyway. He had one of these the other day and I thought, well, they look quite good. And I do like a vegetable bake, I must admit. So, we're going to try one and see what it's all about. It says it's Greg's vegetable bake, so, I don't know. Should be good then, eh? Right, so stick around for 20 minutes or so, and hopefully that's what it's going to turn out like. Right, folks, it goes in the oven for 32 minutes. 32, that's a long time, isn't it? We'll just check it after 25, though, because these things in that furnace, this is the oven of ours. It's basically like a microwave that oven down there, it just does something really fast. So we'll check it after 25 minutes.